Hello students, welcome back to the Science Online classes. I am Jafar Basha, your science teacher. Dear students, let's begin the today's chapter, life processes. The question is, what are life processes? To understand these life processes, we must know about the functions of our body. Have you observed that the maintenance functions keeps on going in our body even when we are not doing any work? Or just when we are sitting into the class, or otherwise when we are sleeping. So these maintenance jobs are keeps on going in our body. Understood? These maintenance jobs are takes place within the body. So the processes which together perform these maintenance jobs are called as life processes. Once again, I will repeat, the processes which together perform these maintenance jobs are called life processes. These life processes needs energy to perform, and this energy must comes out of the body of an organism. This energy is very important to perform the functions. So that's why there must be a process to transfer the source of energy from outside the body of an organism to inside. This process is commonly called as nutrition. What do you mean by nutrition? The process of transfer of source of energy from outside the body of an organism to the inside. This is called as nutrition. Let's know more about the nutrition, how the nutrition process takes place in living organisms. Okay? So the living organisms are generally classified into two groups. One is unicellular organisms and another one is multicellular organisms. Generally the organisms are classified into two groups. First one is unicellular organism. Unicellular means the organisms which are made up of by single cell. And the multicellular means the organisms which are made up of by more than one cell. Comes, let's know what type of nutrition takes place in unicellular organisms. So as you know that one, unicellular organisms, examples, yes, you can tell me, amoeba, paramecium, euglena, some of the other bacteria, so they are all concentrated in unicellular organisms. So I have taken that one example of amoeba. Let's see how the nutrition takes place in amoeba. As you know that one, amoeba are not having a definite shape. So the amoeba, when it senses the food nearby its body, it produces their false feet. The false feet is nothing but these are the false feet, which is also called as pseudopodia. So these are pseudopodia. With the help of these pseudopodia, the amoeba will move towards the food material. As it reaches to the food materials, it extends the pseudopodia and covers the food materials. As it covers the food materials, the body of an amoeba will take the food inside the body through the process called diffusion. Understand? Through the process of diffusion, the amoeba takes in the food into the body. When it enters into the body, it forms a food vacuole. The food vacuole starts secreting the digestive juices to digest the food. The digested food will supply to all the remaining part of the amoeba through the process called diffusion. At the same time, the cell will produce the waste material. This waste material will move at the part of the amoeba and throw outside the body again through the process called diffusion. So that's why we can conclude that the unicellular organisms are taking place that their life processes through the process called diffusion. Understood? But this diffusion process will not sufficient to the multicellular. Why? Because in unicellular organisms, the entire body of an organism will in direct contact with the environment. But in the multicellular, all the cells will not in direct contact with the environment. Thus, a simple diffusion process will not meet the requirements of multicellular organisms. Now, comes to that one, multicellular organisms. In multicellular organisms, the new multicellular organisms are having two types of nutrition. One is autotrophic nutrition, another one is heterotrophic nutrition. What do you mean by this autotrophic nutrition? The autotrophic nutrition means the nutrition in which the organisms can prepare their own food. Understood? They can prepare their own food self. So that's why they are called as autotrophs, which means self-food producers. Once again, I will repeat. The autotrophs means the organisms which can prepare their own food. So they are called as autotrophs. Then heterotrophs. Heterotrophs means the organisms which cannot prepare their own food, but they are depending directly or indirectly on the autotrophs. So let's begin that one. What type of nutrition will take place in autotrophs? The autotrophs are preparing their food, or otherwise the nutrition will take place through the process called photosynthesis. Then the question is, what is photosynthesis? The photosynthesis means the process of preparing food by using inorganic materials such as sunlight, carbon dioxide, water and minerals, etc. This is process is called as photosynthesis. As a result of photosynthesis, the plants can prepare their own food in the form of starch. Let's see that one, the chemical equation. How can we write that one photosynthesis equation? First, the plants will take that one carbon dioxide, the 6 molecules of carbon dioxide plus 12 molecules of water. The plants contains the green color pigment called chlorophyll. Hence, they can prepare their own food with the help of chlorophyll. The chlorophyll is very important to absorb the sunlight. That's why we are writing the plants taking the 6 molecules of carbon dioxide, 12 molecules of water which contains the chlorophyll, and the chlorophyll absorbs the sunlight and the food is prepared in the form of starch C6H12O6. At the same time, the plants will release the 6 molecules of oxygen and the 6 molecules of water. So this is the chemical reaction of a photosynthesis. Once again, we will repeat, the 6 molecules of carbon dioxide plus 12 molecules of water, which is in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, the food C6H12O6 will produce. At the same time, 6 molecules of oxygen will release and 6 molecules of water also release as a byproduct. Understood, everyone? The plants will take the carbon dioxide. The carbon dioxide, as you know, that one, the plant leaves contains the small minute pores called stomata on the lower surface of the leaf. These stomata will help to exchange of the gases. So that's why through the stomata, the plants absorb the carbon dioxide, and through the root hairs which is present in the soil. So it means the soil can get, so soil can provide the water to the plants. The root hairs absorb the water and supply to the leaf of a plant through the xylem tissue, which is a water conducting tissue. So by using this carbon dioxide and water, the chlorophyll which is present itself into the leaf will absorb the sunlight directly, and with the all combination, they can prepare their food as a starch. Understood? Let's know what's actually going on during the photosynthesis. During the photosynthesis, the absorption of light energy will take place. The first step is absorption of light energy will take place. The second step is the conversion of light energy into chemical energy. At the same time, the water molecules will split into hydrogen and oxygen. This is the next second step. The third step is finally the carbon dioxide will converted into carbohydrates. This is all about the nutrition will takes place in autotrophs. Okay, after the autotrophs, let's know that one, the heterotrophs. Heterotrophs means the organisms, other organisms except the green plants are all considered in heterotrophs. The, for example, animals, birds, human beings, etc., they are all heterotrophs. So in that heterotrophs, I've taken the example of human being. Let's know what type of nutrition will take place in human beings. So to know that one, we know that the digestive system of an human beings. Come, let's know that one. Okay, so this is the digestive system of human beings, which having that one, the parts of the digestive system starts from mouth, which having that mouth cavity. They are having that one epiglottis. The epiglottis situated in the throat region. Then it enters that one esophagus, which is called as food pipe. The after the food pipe, they are having that one stomach. After the stomach, they are having pancreas, they are having liver. After that one, the food enters into the small intestine. After the small intestine, the large intestine, then the rectum, the anus. The anus having the anal sphincter, so that one, the undigested food is released out. Understood everyone? The digestion involves the following steps: ingestion, digestion, assimilation, absorption, and egestion. The first step, ingestion. We take food into the mouth. The mouth contains teeth and tongue, which helps to chew the food and mixes the saliva. Saliva contains enzymes called salivary amylase, which made the complex food into simple sugars. Then the food pushed into the esophagus, which is called food pipe, through the epiglottis. The food moves in esophagus in a rhythmic way called peristaltic movement. You can see the food is moves into the esophagus through the peristaltic movement. And then finally the food falls into the stomach, which contains hydrochloric acid, mucus, and digestive enzymes called pepsin. Hydrochloric acid creates the acidic medium into the stomach, which helps to act the pepsin on food. Mucus helps to protect the inner walls of the stomach against the hydrochloric acid. As you know, hydrochloric acid is a very danger. It can damage the inner walls. So that's why mucus protects the inner walls of the stomach. Then after becoming acidic medium, the food enters into the small intestine, where complete digestion takes place. Pancreas secretes pancreatic juice and the liver secretes bile juice in the small intestine. Bile juice made the food alkaline to act the enzymes on food. Pancreatic juice acts on fats and converts them from big globules to small globules. Then intestine itself secretes their enzymes such as trypsin and lipase. Trypsin acts on the protein and lipase acts on the fats. Finally, carbohydrates converted into glucose, protein into amino acid, and fat into fatty acids and glycerol. Small intestine contains finger-like projections called villi, which are richly supplied with the blood vessels. Will absorbs the digested food. After absorption of digested food, the undigested food pushed to the large intestine, where the absorption of water takes place. You can see that one, this is in a large intestine where the water absorbs from the undigested food. Finally, the undigested food pushed out of the body through the anus, which contains anal sphincter.
You can see that one, this is a large intestine. From that one, the food is moving out of the body. This is an anus and this is moving outwards.
So dear students, you saw that one, how the nutrition processing takes place in the human beings. Like that one, that nutrition takes place in the unicellular organisms, multicellular organisms such as autotrophs and heterotrophs. This is all about the today's lesson, life process. In that one we take on the topic nutrition. Hope you understood. Stay safe, stay at home. Thank you. We can continue the next topic, that is respiration, into the next class. Thank you very much.